That has nothing to do with my profit. Please just stop it. It doesn't make any sense. That's not the message he sent. That's not what he meant. That's not why he came. So you can claim as much as you want to, but I assure you the man I follow was not the same. See, I know a man who forbade the cutting down of a plant, who even spoke against those who had burnt an ant. So why is it that I simply can't understand how we claim to follow the same man? I mean, I know a man who forbade us from harming the innocent, saying he who does so would not only be prohibited from paradise, but he would not even smell its scent. So please tell me how what you're doing has anything to do with the message that he sent. This is the man who forbade us from even scaring cattle with a knife, saying you have no right to let the animal die twice. And when he was asked for advice, he'd reply, "Don't get angry, don't get angry, don't get angry," repeating it thrice. See, I know a man who called to patience first, even to those who had treated him the worst. And when he was asked to invoke Allah's wrath, he said, "I was not sent to curse, but rather as a mercy to the earth, matter of fact, the entire universe, meaning everything that was made." See, this is a man whom the clouds would rush to shade, a man to whom the trees would sway and the birds would flock to seek his aid. For they knew he was a man of justice, a man who would never betray, a man who could be trusted even by those who had wanted him slain. Anas bin Malik served him for 10 years and not once had he heard him complain. For he would never get angry for himself, but only for Allah's sake. And he never responded to evil with evil, but rather he pardoned and forgave. For had he been harsh-hearted, the people would have ran away. So what is it that we still don't understand when we claim to follow Islam, yet we fail to follow this man? I mean, I know a man who was so caring and compassionate, who said that there is a reward in serving all things that are animate. In other words, everything that breathes, whether it be the animals, the trees, and every single human being. I mean, if Allah called him Rahmatan lil Alameen, how dare you call him anything else that contravenes? See, this is a man who said that the Muslim was he who is soft, simple, and lenient. A man who taught us himself to be cautious from falling into extremism. See, he was never given two choices except he chose that which was easiest. Not for himself, but for his people and their convenience. See, I know a man who advocated for the freedom of the slaves. A man who taught us that the Muslim is the one from whom the people are safe. Not only from his hands, but even from the words that he says. See, this is a man who would never mock, mimic, nor ridicule, nor would he ever publicly rebuke an individual. This is the man I follow, so forgive me if this sounds unusual. But the man I know was so much more handsome, so beautiful. A man who taught kindness to the neighbors, who taught us to serve others without expecting back any favors, to spread peace to those we know and even to the strangers, to walk with humility and to simply ignore the haters. But nevertheless, I know a man who still taught us to stand up for the oppressed, from the men, women, and children who call out to us in distress. I know a man who taught us to fight for these people, but by no means does this mean we have the right to transgress. For those who oppress have nothing to do with his name. So you can say what you wish to say and continue to defame his name, but at the end of the day, I assure you, the man I follow was not the same. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
If you're not careful, the media will have you hating the people who are oppressed and loving the people who are doing the oppressing. The fact that Islam gets so much press today is like a curse and a blessing. A blessing because nobody can say on the day of judgment that they didn't hear this message, and a curse because we were the ones who were supposed to be delivering it to the masses. And here we are, trying to sell God to a world that is godless, content with chasing the pursuit of happiness and arms instead, burying little baby girls in these shallow graves of Instagram fame, selling breasts and thighs like KFC, we have lost all shame. Today, you cannot even call immorality by name. The idols of yesterday have been replaced by the American idols of today, and we can comfortably say that tribalism and racism are here to stay. A black man is still considered less than a white man on any given day. In every single way, we have lost our way, gone astray with so many freedoms, yet we are locked in a cage. For this dunya has no friends, only one night stands, and we keep getting screwed, chasing mirages in the sand, and there is no way out, no control, alt, delete, no disconnecting from this matrix. It is stuck on repeat and repeat and repeat and repeat and repeat. No more books of guidance, no more messengers to meet, no more wahi from the skies. Our connection is so weak, and we've been given everything that we need to be convinced, but it's so hard to fight ignorance when Abu Jahl still exists. Because I'm tired of feeling different, tired of apologizing for what I didn't do, tired of trying to explain the truth to buffoons who just want to tie me in a noose. I'm tired of feeling tired, knowing that I could be doing so much more, but I'm a coward and a sinner, and I don't even know if I deserve to even really have my last name. Trying to uphold the principles of a man whom the angels praised, and sometimes I wonder if my prophet were alive today, would this world we see today still be the exact same way? Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. May Allah send him blessings and peace. Because if our prophet had a passport, I wonder what would be his nationality. Would he be a Saudi? Would they call him a Wahhabi? Would he enjoy the luxuries of all these royal families? The man who used to sleep on a bed of palm leaves, would he live inside a mansion with servants at his feet? And I wonder, what would be his stance on foreign policy? Could he eat knowing how many children die from poverty and invading armies, dropping bombs indiscriminately, harming innocent moms, killing for fun? The man who taught us that this ummah was one. Would he educate and eradicate ignorance with his tongue, or pick up a gun to anyone who said that God was not one? Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But tell me, how could this be? The man who was sent as rahmatan lil alameen, and he couldn't even read, not alif, lam, or meme, yet he would change the hearts of a generation. And everyone that would proceed taught us that every life was sacred, and to have respect for humanity because we were all created from a single clot and seed. And I could see him at the UN addressing all the other nations, warning them of global warming and religious innovations. CNN would ask for an interview. His words would be short and sweet, but they would still find ways to misinterpret and demonize him on TV. Oh, he must be crazy or suffering from some kind of insanity to think the rich shouldn't oppress the poor or take advantage of the weak. And what do you mean when you say that all men are the same except in piety? This is blasphemy. We've been living this way for so many centuries. They would charge Abu Bakr as an accomplice. Uthman would be entrapped, put Umar in solitary confinement, and give Ali accessory after the fact. Khalid bin Walid would be labeled a menace to society, and Bilal's face would be on the front of every Black Lives Matter tee. I pray for humanity, because we are pray for humanity. In the past, they killed prophets, took Yahya's head off with a sword. Now they kill for prophets, justifying their unholy war, spreading blood like gospel. Now more than ever before, it feels like we need a prophet to guide us through the eye of the storm. But if we did, I would request on Facebook to be his friend, or send him a DM on Instagram just to say, hey, I'm a big fan. You may not know me, but I've read all about you and you really helped me change my life and I don't know how to thank you. And even though I never met you, I still believe in you. I'm a follower of you. And I follow you on Twitter too. And when I grow up, I want to be just like you. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.